Lake Tanganyika stretches through the Great Rift Valley, the geographic link between Central, Eastern, and Southern Africa. Most people living along the shores continue to depend on fishing and farming, just as they have for thousands of years. The MV Liemba travels the expanse of Lake Tanganyika, playing a critical role in the lives of those in her wake, operating for nearly a century.
She's the queen of Africa.
The thread that ties the people of Lake Tanganyika to one another.
These people living along the coast of this lake depend on Liemba.
Some people travel business, some people travel smuggling along the borders. I've met people of all types and color. There are so many stories inside there, strange ideas.
As a colonial gunship, she spread fear.
Construction was not done by machines. This was done on the backs of the local people. Nobody would have wanted to keep these records of how many people died, but definitely a lot of lives were lost.
For me, colonization was good for Africans. Through colonization, we knew many things. Civilization, evangelization, business, agriculture system.
In 1962, the fortunes of the Liemba, Lake Tanganyika, and all of Tanzania suddenly changed.
He nationalized the land, 1965. We destroyed the agriculture industry, made his country poor.
Premier Nyerere has brought his nation to the promised land of independence.
Very charismatic guy, that man. Without him, there could be no peace.
She has been a catalyst for a common language. As a commissioned UN vessel, she brings hope. Her story is Africa's story.
When you talk of Liemba, it's just like pyramids in Egypt. She's the queen of Africa.
The Liemba is just a fantastic experience, and it's something that everybody should really know about, its history and what it does for the people.